Let's go to the phone lines. Gary, good morning. How you doing?
Good morning, gentlemen.
You're early this morning. We always like it when you're early.
Jason, I try to be on time for you all the time. So.
Well, I get you. If you're not, he gets upset. So just so you know, it's just a heads up there, Gary.
Punctual is his middle name. So, yeah, you guys got me all fired up this morning. You got a couple things for you. First, I'll do two things people think about a fixer-upper, and then three ways to spot a true consultant.
Fantastic.
A couple things you guys kind of got me energized about this morning. So, two things people think about a fixer-upper. Obviously, there's opportunity to add value, opportunity to grow your assets or grow your skills. And, you know, the second thing is typically people think of a fixer-upper as not being in good shape. And I thought, you know, that was kind of a good transition into how we, you know, run our businesses and how we work with our clients. And so, you know, basically I want to ask people, do they have a fixer-upper attitude? You know, can you look at things in your life and see opportunity in it? Can you look at a rusty old car and envision it being restored? Can you do the same thing in your business and for yourself, you know? And it kind of got me excited about the idea of calling members of our group because, you know, as you mentioned earlier this morning, Aaron, is consultative solution providers are really the ones who are helping kind of fix the landscape of the situation out
right,
there in the marketplace.
Right.
So, you know, the three ways to spot a true consultant I thought would be worthwhile mentioning this morning. They ask more questions than they make assumptions.
Yeah, that's a good one. Yeah, that's a very good one.
Secondly, they typically suggest ideas or options you haven't heard before, like the 3% down option you mentioned this morning.
Right,
for
correct.
For example, without PMI. And my favorite one, the one that my mom taught me from when I was very little, is they listen with two ears and one mouth and use them both in proportion.
Right. I get that quite a bit, and that's actually that I was hoping that was going to be one of your points. Actually, I thought for sure it would be, is even consultative solutions doing that stuff over the phone with a customer. Sometimes I will get in the middle of the conversation. The client will say, "Are you there?" And I said, "Yeah, I'm just listening." You know,
so and that's a surprise.
That is a surprise because in today's market, you're so used to getting on the phone and getting bombarded by all this information, but when your client actually goes, "Hello, yeah, I'm just listening, taking notes," you know, and that kind of stuff, and you can interject as you go.
Well, there's a huge difference between, you know, a salesperson and a consultant. And, Gary, I mean, you bring up some great points. I mean, is the person you're working with, are they giving you information? Are they helping you? Are they listening? Or are they trying to sell you something? And I think, you know, you hit on all the things that are important. You know, I would like to think that all of us, you know, all four of us are more consultants than we'll ever be salespeople. And I think that that's one of the reasons why we've been successful over the years is because we want to help and consult and give information.
And it's why we partner with companies like Fuse Marketing and why we put M and Home Talk together in the first place.
Absolutely, absolutely. Gary,
that's a great point, gentlemen. And the most important part I think that I really get to enjoy about our group is that, you know, we constantly are looking for new ways and new ideas to help each other, but I always say if you spend all your energy trying to give the person you're working with what they want, you'll never have to wonder or worry or hope for what you want. So
that's fantastic.
I'll leave you guys with that. Thanks for having me on the show. Good, keep it going.
Hey, thanks, Gary.